Hey everyone, and welcome back to some more esports talk. Of course, in what was supposed to be the last dance tournament in Warzone, that is the last tournament before we had Vanguard come out and release, there were a lot of issues, and it would not be a Warzone tournament without some accusations involved. However, before we got into that, of course, we saw people like TimTheTatman, Dr Disrespect, already confused about the rules going into this last tournament.
Hey, Whips, Cali sticks aren't allowed, right?
Dude, I just beat people's ass.
Let him in. Come on in my house.
Oh yeah. We have no loot here.
What if I run reshot claymores, bro? Thoughts?
I didn't think claymores were allowed. It's actually not a horrible idea.
Claymores are allowed, right? Right? 100%. Chat. I'm not crazy.
Well, you've thrown like four down, so.
Yeah, claymores are allowed.
However, like I said, that was definitely not the worst part of the whole ordeal, as we have a streamer and competitor who I believe his name is pronounced Osvum, but I might be just butchering that, so I'm sorry in advance, but he was accused of cheating after the following clips.
Time to earn your freedom.
What you saw there was that initial clip of him in the Gulag, which had people starting to accuse him because he was pre-aiming somewhere that they thought there was no way that they could know that that person was right there in the Gulag. Then the part that really sent a lot of people and put the whole tournament on delay was when he pulled up his task manager to prove that he was in fact not cheating and that there was no program on there that he would be using. People could not see it on his monitor. And so if you go back and watch at that bottom right where it says or where it shows all three of his monitors, you can't see the task manager actually pop up on the screen. And so people were concerned that maybe he was showing not actually his screens, but he does go on to explain the situation later on after all of these accusations happened.
Okay, so first monitor, stream PC, right? Game monitor two, and then my task manager is on the third screen, but look, if I drag it to the side, it starts coming into play on the left monitor, and look, it goes over my game right here. So that's just like, that's just how the game is capturing. Hold on, I can't send it. Okay, now it's in between this monitor and the Elgato. So it goes in between.
Boom TV, that is the host of the tournament, went on to explain the situation both on Twitter and in a private message, with the message saying task manager didn't show on his monitor cam because his Elgato capture card was being output to OBS, shows up as a virtual monitor. So to show his task manager, he dragged it to the virtual monitor. Also, per the clip, you see Scum's legs as he wraps to the right. Plus, they just entered OT in the Gulag, hence the urgency of pre-firing. Also, Boomhead Asvim stopped his stream when they went through his PC, and he was super cooperative, and it has been concluded that he was not cheating. Then on Twitter, they said after reviewing the content in question, the competitor has cooperated fully, and at this time, there has been no indication of cheating. Competitor complied with us viewing his machine, as well as opening up his computer to be viewed and questioned by those involved in the event. And it really sucks that we've been put in the situation where there are so many accusations constantly. I think FIFA Kill had a good little thread on it where he said the guy has been accused, not caught. It's good they're looking into it and making sure, but don't say horrible things to the guy or some conclusions before the right checks have been done. With Juki saying, the anti-cheat can't come quick enough, so guys like this can just crack on and not worry about being accused.
That's the clip that's getting circulated here? Wait, Whips, are you fucking serious?
Is it bad?
It's nothing. The fuck are we doing here?
So yes, in the $75,000 last dance tournament on Warzone, we of course had some accusations that ended up delaying the entire tournament. It really does suck that we're in a spot where there's so much hacking and cheating that as soon as people see pre-firing, they assume that the streamer is cheating and it has to take this whole delay. It took over an hour, I believe. And so it really does suck. Hopefully Vanguard will fix some of those problems with Ricochet, but who knows, right? We don't have a whole lot of hope because we know what Warzone is. We know what to expect at this point. Let me know what you guys think about all this. And until next time, I'll catch you later.